In the past videos, we took apart lots of USB-A and USB-C chargers, but it seems like we've never talked about the USB-B connector. What it looks like and how can we use it? Let's talk about it today. In the last century, it was difficult for users to connect external devices to a PC. Different devices were not compatible and drivers must be installed. Until the USB standard came out, these problems were gradually solved. The USB standard was first released in 1996 and is maintained by USBIF. USB 2.0, USB 3.0, and USB 4 are different specifications, providing different speeds. The physical connectors can be divided into USB Type-A, USB Type-B, and USB Type-C. And our today's protagonist has two types of Type-B and Type-B Super Speed. For now, the USB-B can support up to USB 3.1 specification, and the maximum transmission speed is 10 gigabits per second. From the schematic, ChargerLAB found its signal are transmitted over twisted pairs marked with D+ and D-. The two half duplex differential signals can work together to offset the interference of long cables. Here is the internal design of the USB Type-B male connector. The first pin is VBUS, 4.75 to 5.25 volts. The second and third pins are D- and D+, respectively. And the last pin is for grounding. With the increasing demand for data transmission speed and different functions, those four pins are insufficient for daily use. The thickness of the USB-B port cannot be adapted to thinner products. But in some cases, it's still common. You can look around the office and check the printers, fax machines, scanners, and some old monitors. You may find that they have USB-B ports on the back or bottom. That's because the USB-B port is mainly used for unidirectional data transmission, like uploading. And the small square in the middle makes the connection more stable than the USB-A and USB-C connector, so it's more common in commercial and industrial use. Okay, that's the brief introduction to the USB-B connector. Hope you can solve your doubts about this connector. You can also click the corners to learn more power-related knowledge. See you in the next video. Bye!